you look at every club last year, and with no expansion this season, the ability to obviously to list some of your weaker talent at the bottom end last year and top them up with some exceptional young talent coming through is only going to make the competition and the standard a lot better. And certainly having Damien and I both worked in the youth skill space the last 3 or 4 years, the talent that's coming through is amazing. And you know, their football brain and their IQ and their skills and their professionalism is something that is going to see a lot of players play this year, and coming through the next couple of years is going to make the competition pretty exciting to be a part of. You know, we need to improve in every area, like every club. Year one was a bit of suck and see because of the competition, 16 aside, no one exactly knew what was going to happen because the game had never played with 16 aside. So to see that unfold now and have actually, you know, 10 months to plan for a 16 aside comp game and competition in season two gives a chance to explore new things and experiment with new ideas. And no doubt Carlton would have done the same thing as us, and you know, we'll see some few things tomorrow night that no one would have expected. Year one, it was interesting to work with these athletes coming into an elite environment for the first time, and a lot of them were local footballers coming into professional facilities, and a lot of them didn't have their footy IQ that general male under 18s coming through the system would have, so their footy IQ wasn't that high. So year one, I reckon a lot of teams probably overcoached early, and then when they, you know, refined it back and kept it basic, things started to happen. But certainly season two, with 12 months of experience, footy IQ from most of the players has increased, so that advancement in coaching and playing is something that you can take with a lot more positivity going forward. Well, certainly we have to be a lot quicker at the start of the season, and you know, we had momentum winning 3 of our last 5 and arguably should have been in Brisbane in round 3, and then you know, we had a shot on goal with 12 minutes to go against Adelaide to go 13 points up. So if we kicked that, you know, we could have probably beaten the Premier. So we had a lot of momentum come the second half of last season, and we know that we can't start that slow this year, because in a 7-week season, that if you start that slow again, you're pushing uphill, and we can't do that this year. We need to start a lot better. And in a 7-week season, it's not just the win and loss ratio, it's also the percentage. So we need to make sure that if we're getting beaten at the source or beating on the scoreboard, we've got to make sure that we don't just lay down and fall over and allow teams to kick a couple of late goals, because percentage in this competition is crucial. So you need to make sure that you keep playing out the full 72, 75 minutes of the game to ensure that you don't have any blowouts.
And Wayne, how's Moana Hope looking for this season? There was a lot of pressure on her in season one. She was put under the microscope. She was essentially the face of the league. How's she coping coming into season two?
Mo's been great, but so has the 29 other of her teammates. Since pre-season, they've all lost weight, they've all conditioned themselves well, they've all improved their strength, and the whole team's body transformation's been amazing. They've all turned themselves into becoming athletes now and not just local footballers. So Mo, with her other 29 teammates, have been fantastic in that area, and it gives every player the opportunity that they can run out games, they can be fitter and stronger, and that's going to help. And we know how good of a ball user she is and decision maker. You don't kick 100 goals in a season if you can't win the footy and kick the ball. So, you know, looking forward to seeing what she can do with her 20 other teammates this week.